telling you, you go out and play and don't get yourself in any trouble, you hear?
Honk.
Soon she found herself at the Windy Farm on the other side of the stream and suddenly heard a call.
Psst! Yoo-hoo! Psst! Yoo-hoo!
Who could be calling me?
Over here!
Being very curious, Petunia went over to see who could be calling her. She found a big gander in a small yard enclosed by a wire fence.
Whoa, good day. My name is Charles.
Mr. Gander.
You are very pretty. Who are you?
I am Petunia.
Blushed Petunia with a smile.
You are very handsome.
Oh, no. I am too fat. I am being fattened for Christmas dinner. Alas, I fear I shall be roasted and served with applesauce. Are you being fattened too?
Pets are fattened,
said Petunia indignantly.
I am a pet.
Why didn't you come and be a pet with me, too?
Mr. Pumpkin, my farmer, is a very nice man.
Well, I would love that, Petunia, but I am a prisoner here, and the gate is never open. Well, my farmer, he opens it when he brings me my corn, but he always closes it behind him. Oh, Petunia, if you could only help me escape.
Why, of course I will.
Promise, Petunia.
Christmas is 3 weeks away. That gives me time to think and do something.
Wait for me. I'll be back soon.
Okay.
So Petunia plodded back to the farm, her heart full of the handsome gander, and her head full of ideas to free him. When she reached the farm, she wasted no time. She quickly made herself into a hideous fairy tale monster. Why, she looked so fierce. She looked so fierce, she even scared herself when she looked in the mirror. When she got back to the Windy Farm, she hid and waited for the farmer to come out. She waited and waited until her feet became very cold. And for goose feet, that's very, very cold. Finally, the farmer came out, and soon he unlocked the gate. Petunia shot out and he made a terrific war hunt.
Help me! Help me! It's a flying dragon!
The farmer fled to the house, leaving the gate wide open. Charles came out and went over the hill with Petunia, free at last. But that's not all. This time, the farmer, armed with his gun, came out looking for the flying dragon. He followed the tracks right into Mr. Pumpkin Jar.
Well, neighbor, what you gonna do on my farm with that big gun?
I came to shoot the flying dragon that stole my prize gander.
Said,
flying dragon?
Look, it's tracked and he'd run into your barn.
At that moment, Petunia came running out of the barn, honking her loudest honk.
Honk!
But Farmer Windy did not run, for this time he had his gun and he aimed it.
Don't shoot, that's Petunia. I know her voice anywhere.
Petunia? What's that?
Why, she's my pet goose. Why, neighbor, she almost scared me too.
While Mr. Pumpkin admired Petunia's war paint, Farmer Windy found Charles hiding in the barn.
You'll escape me no more.
A 20-pound goose at 75 cents a pound is more than I can afford to lose.
Oh, poor Petunia, how she cried. She loved Charles so. But then she thought about what the farmer had said.
20-pound goose at 75 cents a pound.
A 20-pound goose at 75 cents a pound? That's a lot of money. I'm going to earn it. I'll buy Charles' freedom myself.
So she found a Santa hat and a cup and went out on the corner to earn Charles' freedom.
Why, here you go.
Here's some money.
Here you go. I know it's Christmas. I know everyone needs money.
Have yourself a good Christmas.
When Christmas Eve came, Petunia finally had enough money to buy her Charles' freedom. But was it too late? Christmas was so near. She nearly flew to the Windy Farm with her cup of coin. As she approached the yard, she saw the
animal
raising Farmer Wendy.
Honk, honk, honk!
Farmer Wendy stopped short. She offered a cup of coin in exchange for Charles' freedom. Farmer Wendy was good-hearted.
Oh, well, shucks. Charles is free. Keep the coins and have a Merry Christmas.
Charles and Petunia thanked the kind farmer and went over the hill and lived happily ever after.